The last thing you want in your yard is one of these. But there is no quick way to resolve an issue if you do get into a jam. You're at your wit's end, not sure what to do. And then you get a letter that promises to help you keep your home. Or perhaps you saw a flyer at the grocery store from a company claiming to have helped others in your neighborhood facing the same problem. Maybe someone knocked on your door claiming to be able to help you stay in your home. What you do next could affect whether or not you stay in your home. We are talking with Arizona Attorney General Terry Goddard. Can you tell us more about the foreclosure issue here in Arizona?
We've all heard the numbers and seen the sad stories on television and in the newspaper. Starting with a housing crisis and compounded by unemployment and a variety of hardships, families are having difficulty making their monthly mortgage payments and are now facing the very real possibility of losing their homes. Unfortunately, foreclosures are all too common in our neighborhoods.
What should a homeowner do if they are facing foreclosure?
Well, if you or someone you know is falling behind their payments and having problems making the monthly mortgage payments, contact your lender immediately. Don't ignore the problem and explain your situation so together you can find a solution that best fits your individual circumstances. There are resources available to help you. Nonprofit housing counseling agencies are all across the state of Arizona and can provide free assistance to homeowners facing foreclosure.
What other resources are available for struggling homeowners?
There are a variety of additional free resources available through my office, the Attorney General's office. We have workbooks, we have information brochures, and our Foreclosure Resource Center website is there to help you. The Arizona Foreclosure Prevention Helpline is also a very important resource.
Thank you for calling NHS Phoenix. This is Patricia. How can I help you?
Patricia Garcia Duarte is with Neighborhood Housing Services of Phoenix. Patricia, what advice can you give to homeowners who are facing foreclosure?
Your lender or a certified housing counselor is your best option to help you if you are facing foreclosure. Keep making your payments to the lender and don't sign any documents unless they come directly from your lender.
Unfortunately, people need to beware that there are also many unscrupulous companies preying on struggling homeowners. They offer foreclosure rescue and loan modification guarantees. It's important that you know the facts and protect yourself and seek help when you need it from your lender and from legitimate housing counselors.
Can you tell us a little bit about these foreclosure rescue and mortgage loan modification scams?
If you're at risk of losing your home, these claims sound like a way out. These people will tell you that they can save your home, that they've helped others in very similar situations. They'll tell you they have special relationships with all the banks, and they'll negotiate the best deal for you. Don't believe it. They're scams. Now, there's a new state law prohibiting these foreclosure consultants from charging an upfront fee for their services. It goes into effect in July of 2010. Hopefully, that will eliminate many of these scam artists.
How do they find homeowners who are in trouble?
They use a lot of different ways to find troubled homeowners. They might advertise on the internet, television, or newspaper. Some even send out personalized letters to homeowners and post signs in your neighborhood.
How we got into this foreclosure crisis is complicated, but for a homeowner who's in trouble, are there some general rules that they should keep in mind as they try to resolve the problem?
Absolutely. You should know who you're dealing with and don't fall for a quick fix. The very best advice I can give someone who's in trouble with their mortgage is to keep making their mortgage payments to their lender. Work directly with that lender for a long-term solution and seek free, legitimate help from a HUD-approved nonprofit housing counseling agency. I encourage you to trust your instincts. Remember, if it sounds too good to be true, it's probably a scam.
If you do get scammed, the Attorney General's office is where you should report it. Be sure to have all the pertinent information available, any copies of the materials you were sent, names and contact information. The more information you can provide, the better.